All right, so our first learning objective in this unit is to identify major ethical issues central to animal rights and environmental ethics. Why don't we just go ahead and break these down, and we'll do this in order. So first, animal ethics. You know, the most fundamental philosophical question here concerns whether or not animals have rights. You know, do animals have rights? All right, I have the right to life, liberty, pursuit of happiness, the freedom of speech. Do animals have similar rights? Does an animal have a right to life? Or are animals here solely to ensure the happiness, to sate the appetite, to provide clothing for humans? And how you feel about that question will largely determine, I think, how you will respond to ethical issues about animal rights. All right, so this is an opportune point in the course to discuss the idea of rights more broadly. Can either utilitarians or Kantians provide us with a satisfactory account of rights, or do we need a broader ethical theory in order to account for the existence of rights? Should rights be thought of as natural or as, in some sense, artificial? And I'll just take a moment here and note that something can be artificial, but also be quite real. So think about this question, right? Are our rights natural? As the Constitution says, are they inalienable rights? Are they God-given rights? Or are they something, a construct of society that, you know, as we've become more educated and more aware, that we've decided, you know, it's not right for people to take advantage of other people. So let's go ahead and you know, we'll label this term rights, and we'll say that all people have the right to be free. So is this something, do you feel this is something that is natural, or that's something that is socially constructed or artificial? So where do they come from, right? If they're natural, do they come from some higher being? Do they come from the collective unconscious? If they're artificial, do they come from society? Do they come from learned men and women? Are these something that are artificial and constructed? So if rights then are natural, or if they're artificial, right, what does that mean then for animals? If we are saying that rights are natural, then that they come from God or come from some type of higher being, what does that mean then for animals? Do animals not then have that same access to those rights? Are animal rights seen more as artificial? That as we have become more aware, as we have become more industrialized, more higher tech, we've seen death and killing of animals not as something that is required for life, but as something that is harmful, right? The second that pigs become pets, we suddenly become less willing to kill pigs. If animals have artificial rights, that yes, they have some rights, but their primary role is provide, you know, food or like nutrients for humans, then do issues like how an animal dies, does it matter? If an animal lives and dies humanely or inhumanely, does it really matter? Does the quality of an animal's life matter if that animal doesn't have any rights? So some things to certainly think about. If animals do have rights, further questions concern the scope and the strength of those rights. So precisely which rights do non-human animals have, and how do we deal with conflicts between the exercise of human and animal rights? Humans have the right to own animals. Does that mean that a human has the right to do with that animal whatever they want? So this gets into topics like animal abuse, right? If an animal doesn't have rights, then a human can do whatever they want with that animal. They can choose to feed it or not feed it. They can choose to bring it in during winter or not. But if animals have some rights, in addition to humans having rights, and suddenly this issue becomes slightly more complicated. Of course, even if animals do not have rights per se, virtually everyone will agree that they have interests. And we may have strong moral reasons or even obligations to respect those interests. And this brings up a broader philosophical issue, the question of whether rights and obligations are necessarily reciprocal, such that, human X has an obligation to animal Y with respect to Z, if and only if Z has the right to demand Y from X. So, as is noted in the textbook, it should be emphasized that different kinds of animals may have very different moral statuses. Now, think about an animal, and what animals do you think are appropriate to eat, and which animals are not appropriate to eat? So we look at a cow. So, okay, yeah, a cow. We should eat a cow. Okay, and what about a chicken? Okay, I don't think many of you have problems eating chickens. What about a horse? How do you feel about a horse? Mind you, in some cultures, horses are considered food. I remember my grandfather served an Italian dish that called for horse meat. At the time, I didn't know what I felt about eating horse. How about a dog? How do you feel about eating dog? Again, some cultures, eating dog is just fine. I think in American society, we look at eating dog and eating cat as something that is barbaric. And those are pets. Those are animals that live in the house, that are man's best friend. So how do these animals then get perceived as something different than a chicken or a cow? What is the process by which these animals transcend these other types of animals, that they have more rights? So, right, this gets us thinking that, you know, that some of us may assume that if we believe that some non-human animals have rights, then we must maintain that all non-human animals have rights. So, granting the existence of animal rights mean that spiders merit the same degree of respect as chimpanzees. But of course, this is a mistake. Since the features of one animal, in virtue of which it merits our respect, may not be shared by other animals, right? So in this case of a spider and a chimpanzee, spiders are seen as harmful, as pests, that they don't have much mental capacity, whereas chimpanzees are considered, right, the closest living animal species to humans. They have been proven to have high intellect, that they communicate, they create societies. So do all non-human animals, do they have the same level of rights, the same interests, or is there a hierarchy? And if there is a hierarchy, how do we ethically explain that hierarchy?